everyone, my name is Kathy and I'm so happy to be with you today. During this series, we've been learning about God's different names and how he has different names that can help us understand him better. Today's name is Defender. And the story that we're talking about is a perfect example of how God defends us in all sorts of situations and in ways that we couldn't even imagine. This story can be found in the book of 2 Kings chapter 6, and it's from verses 8 to 23. In this story, there are three main characters. The first one is Elisha, who was a prophet of God. And the other two are two kings. The first one being the king of Aram, who we can call the bad king, and the king of Israel, who we can think of as the good king in this story. Now the king of Aram was at war with the king of Israel, and he met with his officers of the army, with his team, and they decided, we're gonna go set our camp at such and such place. When they made this decision, God spoke to Elisha the prophet, who was with the Israelites, and told him exactly where the king of Aram planned to go. So Elisha went to the king of Israel and said, hey, the Arameans are gonna be in such and such place. And the king of Israel sent some people to go scope out the place, and they saw that Elisha was right, that that's exactly where they were. And this happened time and time again. Every time that the king of Aram met with his team, they would decide, let's go to this place, let's go to that place. And every time God would speak to Elisha and tell him the other army's plan. And the Israelite army always knew what places to avoid or where to be careful because they knew exactly what the other army was planning. Now, eventually you can imagine the king of Aram became angry, enraged. How is it possible that we plan and plan and plan? And the enemy army always knows what we're up to. He decided he knew what was up. Somebody from his team must be betraying him. So he met with his team again and was like, hey guys, come on, which one of you is betraying me? Which one of you is telling the other army our plans, because somebody is telling them exactly what we're doing. And there's no way that they can know. I'm not telling them which one of you is doing it. And the other guys were there like, not me, not me, not me, you know? And one of them said, you know what? It's none of us, but I think I know who it is. He said, there's a prophet named Elisha who is with the Israelites, and God tells him the plans that we make. God tells them the things that you say in your bedroom. And this scared the king of Aram. How is it possible that God can speak to this man and tell him the things that I plan in my home with my team? There's no way. And he became angry even more. So he sent some people to find out where this guy is. Where is this Elisha guy? We need to find him. We need to track him down because we need to eliminate him. We need to get rid of this guy. So some guys went out, they did some digging, and they found out that Elisha was in a place called Dothan. And as soon as the king heard this, he sent a large force of horses and chariots. He sent this army to go there and eliminate Elisha, to go attack and kill him. So this army goes in the nighttime when they believe that nobody's outside, you know, nobody's gonna really see them. They go during the nighttime and they surround the city of Dothan and they wait. Early the next morning, one of Elisha's servants gets up early in the morning like any other day. He goes outside and he sees that the whole city is surrounded by an army of horses and chariots. And he freaks out. He panics. He goes running to Elisha. Elisha, we got a big problem. There's an army outside. They brought horses, they brought chariots. There's an army. What are we gonna do? What's the plan here? Elisha, being the cool, calm, and collected prophet that he was like, okay, relax, don't worry, because those who are with us are more than those who are with them. He knew that God was gonna protect them, that God was gonna defend them. But he knew that this might be a little bit hard for his servant to understand. So he prayed and asked God to open the eyes of the servant to see what he meant. And that's what God did. God opened the eyes of the servant. And when he looked, he saw horses and chariots of fire surrounding Elisha. And that was how he knew that God was with them. He knew exactly what Elisha meant, that the force that was with them, the force of God, was much stronger and much more than the force that was with that enemy army. And as the army of the Arameans approached Elisha and continued getting closer, Elisha prayed again and asked God to strike them with blindness so that they wouldn't be able to see where they were going. And God did just that. He struck the whole army with blindness. So they get to the end where they were arriving. They're just going in a straight line, heading toward full force, you know, trying to find Elisha. All of a sudden they go blind. They don't know where they are. And they arrive at where Elisha is. And they're like, hey, we're looking for a guy named Elisha. You know where he is? So naturally Elisha's like, oh, that guy, he's not here. This isn't the city. This isn't the road that you're looking for, but I'll show you where he is. So he leads this army of blind people to a place called Samaria. And that's where the army of Israel was. He leads them. They have no idea that Elisha, the guy that they were supposed to go look for, is the one guiding them. And when they arrive there, Elisha prays again. And he asked God to open their eyes back up. When their eyes are able to see again, they realize where they are, that they have just landed in the enemy's territory, and that Elisha, the guy that they were looking for, was right there. They were confused, and the king of Israel was confused. He goes to Elisha and is like, what'd you bring this people here for? Because Elisha was the prophet that would tell him on behalf of God what they needed to do. And he's like, what'd you bring these people here for? Am I supposed to kill them? Is that what you did? You brought the enemy army so that I could kill them? And Elisha's like, no, that's not what I was thinking. That's not the plan. How about let's not kill them? Instead, let's prepare some food, some drinks, and let's have a feast with them. And that's what they did. They had a feast together. And then the army of the Arameans got their stuff and went back to their master. And after that, the king of Aram, the Arameans, didn't bother the Israelites for a very long time because they had seen the power of God that was with the Israelites. Not only during the process of God speaking to Elisha and helping them and guiding them on what places to avoid, but even when they intentionally went to try to attack the Israelites, to try to attack Elisha, they saw God's hand again defending them. And just how God defended the Israelites in this story and defended Elisha, he does it with us in our day-to-day lives. Whether it be defending you from a bully at school or defending you from a car that could have hit you when your mom was driving you to the park, there are lots of situations where God's hand protects us and defends us, even when we can't see it, because he cares about us. And that's why we can call God our defender, because he defends us no matter what. I hope that you are able to learn today that God is defending you in any situation or any circumstance that you might encounter. God defends you. And the more you have a relationship with God, the more you pray and read your Bible and have a deeper connection with God, the more you'll be able to hear his voice and know when he's guiding you on what to do and what not to do. So, I hope that you were able to learn something from this story. I hope that you know that God is defending you. Now let's go over our memory verse that we've been saying every week of this series. This verse is in Psalm 9:10, and it says, those who know your name trust in you, for you, O Lord, do not abandon those who search for you. So search for God and he will not abandon you. Search for him and he will defend you. He will provide for you. He will take care of you. And he has got your back in every situation. Now let's pray together. God, thank you so much for this day that you've blessed us with. Thank you for allowing us to learn from this story and to know with full confidence that you defend us. God, I pray that you help us to continue growing our relationship with you, to go deeper and deeper each day, and that you help everyone who watches this video to grow in their relationship with you and grow in their confidence and in their faith of knowing the great God that you are and growing in their understanding of you, God. I know that you guide us in everything and that you will continue to do so. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Bye.